The thing about Voyager is that it got the first close-up view of Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune, these four big giant planets of our solar system, which we'd only had little glimpses of either from a telescope or from flybys that were not carrying very good cameras. And we were able to see not only those planets in gory detail, great red spot, the swirling clouds and so on, as well as the rings on Saturn, but we saw the moons, which were completely separate worlds, complete, each one very different. We thought that they would be a bit like our moon, like a battered bunch of rock and maybe ice. Kind of boring, really, to be honest with you. But no, what we saw were volcanoes, we saw cracks, we saw ice that seems to be opening up, we saw plumes of stuff coming out. It was just amazingly different worlds. Each one was totally different. There are two things that I think are worth really thinking about with a Voyager mission. One was the impact on a whole generation. The impact across the globe on these first glimpses of the outer solar system is huge. Across the globe, there were stories being and books showing what Voyagers found. So the impact on education was huge. Number two, the other big thing is the technology. So the changes in technology between the early 1970s when Voyager was built and put together and sent off into space and now is extraordinary. It's a huge change. Back then, the computer capability is less than a handheld calculator that we had on that spacecraft. When I was a young graduate student, I don't think I quite appreciated how important this project was going to end up being. It was, for me, an opportunity to work on something that was interesting and fun, and I wanted to do planetary science, and space physics was what I was trained in. But then to actually start seeing the data come in was just incredible, because I'd written a little term paper on, well, we might see this with this instrument, and given the instrument capabilities, this is what the signal should look like. And then the day of March 6, 1979, the data was coming in on a printout. So it would little printout on this thing and it would move up and make another wiggly line and look at those wiggly lines, and they were just what I predicted. And I'll never forget that moment.